Hi guys and welcome to my channel. Today I have a haul, a book haul. Originally I ordered 10 books, but only 8 showed up. One got canceled and the second, the 9th book, will be here at some point. So today I only have 8 books to show you, but they are 8 super exciting books, perfect for people who are interested in self-growth and for people who like to learn new things in general. So let's just jump right into the box and look at the books that I bought. So the first book that I ordered is 7.5 Lessons About the Brain, which is written by Lisa Feldman Barrett. And on the front page here it says, "Be warned, you may find your world turned upside down," which is a review by The Guardian. And if I'm being honest, I only bought this book because it's a book about the brain, and I am super excited about the brain these days. I am a biology student and I am currently considering going to neurology, which is why I'm really excited to learn more about the brain. And so this book do have a lot of good reviews on the Goodreads app, which, if you didn't already know, is an amazing app for people who enjoy reading. And on the backside of this book, there is another review from The Guardian, which I thought was really exciting. "I thought it might be fun for people to be able to read a neuroscience book on the beach," Barrett explains. "But be warned, you may find your world turned upside down before it's time for cocktails." So my impression of this book is that it's a light read, but also being really informative, which is perfect because even though it's really exciting to learn about topics like neuroscience, it can be a little bit complicated and complex, and I'm not always in the mood to take a deep dive into a textbook about neuroscience. And thus I think this book will be perfect. I'm really excited to read it. And so the second book that I ordered is this book, which is called The Miracle Morning, 6 Habits That Will Transform Your Life Before 8 a.m., written by Hal Elrod. And apparently it's an international bestseller. I didn't find this book myself. I got it recommended by a bookstagrammer on my bookstagram. She sent me a DM about this book. I recently read The 5 a.m. Club, which in my opinion is a horrible book. It's one of the worst books I've ever read. And I was really bummed about it because I wanted to read a book that is informative and a book that gives specific advice on how to elevate your morning. The 5 a.m. Club did not do that for me. I don't think it will for anybody, but I'm really hopeful about The Miracle Morning. And on the back side it says, "You're about to discover how to create the most extraordinary life you've ever imagined right now." Sounds pretty appealing. What if you could wake up tomorrow and find that any or every area of your life was transformed? What would be different? Would you be happier, healthier, more successful? Would you have more energy, less stress, more money? Which of your problems would be solved? So in my opinion, this sounds like a really exciting book. I am always on the lookout for good books when it comes to self-growth and personal development, and I think this book really checks all of my points on the things that I want to learn. Elevating my morning is something that I'm really keenly interested in, and especially because I'm a student and this book seems to have cool content for me to enjoy. So I'm really excited to read this book. And this book, I don't really have a lot to say about this book, but this is The Overstory, a novel by Richard Powers, which apparently also this book was winner of the Pulitzer Prize and number one New York Times bestseller. And so obviously this is a fiction, it's a novel. I originally heard about this book or read about this book on the Bill Gates blog. He has a book blog, which is amazing, it's really good. And I've found in the past that I really have enjoyed the books that Bill Gates have recommended me through his blog, and mostly I read nonfiction. So every now and then I'm interested in reading a novel or other fiction books. I think that can be a really great way to disconnect from the world and just give yourself a break. And so I was really interested when Bill Gates recommended this book. And honestly, I'm really excited to read a book that I don't really know that much about, because, you know, widening your horizons and being open to new experiences is really cool. So this book I'm really excited about. This is 13 Things Mentally Strong People Don't Do. It is a international bestseller written by Amy Morin. And it says, take back your power, embrace change, face your fears, and train your brain for happiness and success. And who doesn't want that? Normally, I don't really love books that are like, that draws this line between mentally strong people and mentally weak people and that type of mentality. But something about this book intrigued me anyways. So I'm doing this thing where I'm not interpreting the title of the book literally. And so on the back side of the book here, it says sort of the 13 tips that the book is about, which for example is, don't give away your power, don't shy away from change, don't focus on things you can't control, don't fear taking calculated risks, blah blah blah. And by reading the back side of the book, I learned that Amy Morin, the author of the book, is a licensed clinical social worker, college psychology instructor, and psychotherapist. And that sounds pretty cool. So I'm really excited to hear what Amy Morin has to say in this book. Hopefully it won't be a bunch of crap, because sometimes, let's be real, self-help books can be really unhelpful. But I'm really excited to dive into this book. Ooh. And this book I'm really excited about. This is written by Charles Duhigg. I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm sorry if it's wrong. This is the book called Smarter, Faster, Better: The Secrets of Being Productive. And who doesn't want to be productive? I sure do want to be productive. I have read another book from Charles Duhigg, which was The Power of Habit, which was an amazing book that I truly really loved so much. And in many ways, that book changed my life. It's a great read. So if you think that sounds interesting and if you're just 1% intrigued, please do read The Power of Habit. It's a great book. And on the backside of this book, it says, in his international bestseller, The Power of Habit, Pulitzer Prize winner Charles Duhigg explained why we do what we do. Now he applies the same relentless curiosity and masterful analysis to the question, how can each of us achieve more? And being as Charles Duhigg had some pretty insightful discussions in his book, The Power of Habit, I'm really excited to read more about his thoughts in this book, Smarter, Faster, Better. And if I'm being honest, yes, I want to be smarter, faster, better. So I'm probably going to start reading this book pretty soon. You might have heard about this book. A lot of people have. It's a really, really popular book. This is Invisible Women, Exposing Data Bias in a World Designed for Men. This is a book by Caroline Criado Perez. It did win the Science Book Prize in 2019. And on the backside, it says, imagine a world where your phone is too big for your hand, your doctor prescribes a drug that is wrong for your body, in a car accident, you are 47% more likely to be seriously injured. If any of this sounds familiar, chances are that you are a woman. Clearly, this is a book about feminism, which is a topic that I really want to learn more about. I think it's really interesting and in that there are a lot of great books, articles, and thoughts in general about the topic. And I often wish that I knew a lot more about it. And I think it's a topic that it's really important that we educate ourselves on. So I'm really excited about this. It has some great reviews on Goodreads as well. And next, lastly, it is Nudge, Improving Decisions About Health, Wealth, and Happiness. And so the New York Times book review said the following about the book. Engaging and insightful, the conceptual argument is powerful, and most of the author's suggestions are common sense at its best. For that, we should all applaud loudly. And the description of the book is, every day we make choices about what to buy or to eat, about financial investments and our children's health and education, even about the causes we champion or the planet itself. Unfortunately, Ultimately, we often choose poorly. Nudge is about how we make these choices and how we can make better ones. Using dozens of eye-opening examples and drawing on decades of behavioral science research, Nobel Prize winner Richard Thaler and Harvard Law School professor Cass R. Sunstein show that no choice is ever presented to us in a neutral way, blah, 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 blah. And this is a topic that has caught my interest lately. Behavioral psychology. Why do we choose the things that we do? Why do we make certain decisions? That's a really interesting topic to me. Again, it had some great reviews on Goodreads, and I just thought the cover of the book looked really appealing. Probably I was sold after Nudge, Improving Decisions About Health, Wealth, and Happiness. Sometimes I do research on the book that I buy, other times I don't. Back to the 5 a.m. club, didn't do any research before buying the book, didn't really work out, and other times, most times, I get to read some really cool books. And I'm hoping that Nudge is one of those books. And lastly, this is the book that I'm most excited about through this whole video. The Headspace Guide to Meditation and Mindfulness. 10 minutes can make all the difference. A book written by Andy Puddicombe. I'm sorry. Here is the exciting part. If the title wasn't enough for you, Bill Gates, which is, I found this book as well on his blog, he said, if you're thinking about trying mindfulness, this is the perfect introduction, which I do. I really want to try mindfulness. I want to introduce more calm in my life. And Emma Watson said, which if you didn't know, she too is a really insightful reader. That's my opinion. She said, it's kind of genius. Yeah? Huh? And apparently, judging by the backside of the book, because it's written there, this is a book about meditation, but not as you know it. There is no chanting, no sitting cross-legged, there's no need for a particular belief system, and you don't have to commit to extend periods of your time. In this book, Andy shows you how just 10 minutes of meditation per day can bring about life-changing results. That sounds pretty good to me. And the New York Times said, Andy Puddicombe is doing for meditation what Jamie Oliver's doing for food. That's a pretty knockout review. That's pretty good. Sounds pretty good. I have never tried the app Headspace. I don't use it, but I pay for the app Calm way too few times due to the fact that I'm paying for the app. I'm gonna start now, which is why I bought this book, because I really wanna learn more about meditation and maybe be more inspired and motivated to do it. So I hope that this book gives some insight in why you should meditate, how you should meditate, how do you do it? Overall, my opinion is that I bought a lot of exciting books. I can't wait to read all of them. The last book that I'm waiting for is Letters to My Younger Self. I can't really remember who the author was, but it's probably gonna be here pretty soon, and I'm very excited to read that book as well. I have a reading goal in 2022 of reading 50 books, and I'm not gonna reach that goal if I don't have exciting books that I want to read. So this is a great start. Oh, that's great. Thank you. I'm gonna put the books down, I think. Yeah, I lost what I was gonna say, but hopefully you found this video informative. Maybe you were inspired to pick up one of the books that I showed you today. If you were, please let me know in the comment section. I would love to hear it. Or if you have any book recommendations, I read mostly anything and everything. If it's fiction, nonfiction. But truth to be said, I really like to read anything. So if you give me your best book down below, and maybe I'll check it out. Anyway, that was it for my video today. Thank you so much if you made it to the end, and thank you so much for visiting my channel. If you did enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up. Maybe subscribe to my channel, and hopefully I'll see you in my next video. Bye!